Hi, I'm Rebekah Meier, and I'm going to demonstrate today my new creative art textures that I've partnered with Joggles to create. They're really fun. I have three new designs. One is a mandala type, an all over pattern. You can see these are well used already. And a one with script and some greenery on it. So the first one I'm going to work with is this one, the script design. I love script. The thing about this one is you're working in reverse. So right now you can see that it looks normal. But in order for it to print correctly, you're going to place color on it with inks or paints or, you know, whatever you like. And then you're going to put it face down onto a gel plate and then lift the design, and you will come up with, let me find it quickly. Something that looks like this. So I'm using today Distress Oxide inks. This way. Which is a quick and easy way to ink up the gel plate and make a print. So the first thing, like I said, I have the Distress Oxide inks and a brayer and the gel plate. So I'm going to, this is Spice Marmalade, and I will be using Abandoned Coral for the background. And I'm just going to put some color on. And it's very deceptive because it looks like there's hardly any ink on the plate, but you'll see it. Is really full of ink. So then I'm going to take my brayer and I'm just going to get that applied so it's a smooth degree variation of color. And I'm going to take a piece of regular copy paper that you use for your printer, and I'm going to just take my hands and rub the back, and we should have a color background, which we do. So I'm going to move this paper to the side, and I'm going to take my creative art texture, and I'm going to use a vintage photo. And I'm going to ink up my pad, my creative art texture. And in order for this to print correctly, I'm going to take it and put it face down, backwards. And I'm going to press this on the back. And then I'm going to pull this up, and you can barely see anything, but hopefully when I put this on the background, it will be noticeable. Now this depends also on if the ink is dark or lighter, your combinations, and the ink you use on the creative art texture to make a print. It might be too dark, but as with gel printing, it's not always obvious what it's going to be. Oh, this turned out good. You can see that it's really subtle, but it's perfect background. So you can see it better. And everything, since I flipped it over and made the print and then pulled the print, you can see the writing is the way it should be. So I'm going to just set this aside, and I will show you how I create with the other two art textures, creative art textures. For the next print, I've already started putting the ink pad, inking it up on the gel plate. This time I'm using fossilized amber and peacock feathers. And I'm just going to do just like I did with the other one. And I didn't clean my brayer, so we'll see what happens. I'm going to get a little bit of orange, looks like. And I'm going to take my mandala and I'm going to place it down. And I'm going to press again. This one, it doesn't matter. It does have a little bit of writing on it, but it won't interfere. I mean, you won't be able to tell if it's, correct backwards or forwards. So I'm just going to pull it off. You can see a little bit of the design, but again, the oxides, when printing with them, they don't show as much as a paint would. Ooh, I really like this. Okay. So I really, really like this. I don't know what was on the plate. There's a little bit of, or it might have been on the creative art texture, but regardless, I like it. It's very subtle print, and basically why I like these so much is they're fantastic for a background. I mean, they can be used with paints or other media with the creative art texture, but for me, I love creating a nice background. So I could come in with my rubber stamps or even some of my stencils and use this to decorate a little bit more, or I might just leave it as it is. So that, I just love. I love how that turned out. So that is the mandala type design. So last but not least, I'm going to show you the all-over pattern, kind of like a tile pattern for this creative art texture. And I'm using fossilized amber and spice marmalade. And it doesn't have to be the distress ink, oxide inks. It could be the distress or any of your favorite inks, except for permanent ones. You could make it work, but the quickest, easiest, if you're just starting out, are the Distress Oxide inks by Ranger, Tim Holtz. Okay, so I'm just going to ink that up. I'm going to press my design down on the plate. And then I'll pull it up and we shall see what we have. And by the way, I'm using a 6x6 gel plate, which works nicely with the creative art textures because they are, I believe, 6 1/4 by 6 1/4. I believe so. I don't know that for an absolute fact, but ooh, this turned out pretty. So this one, I just got more of the amber coming through, and there was other stuff there must have been on my plate because I didn't get a completely clear print, but I love that. I love it because to use them, I make a little patchwork on this sheet of double-sided adhesive and make a full sheet of material that I can use for just about anything. So now this is sticky. This one of the sides is removed, and I'm just going to lay my sheets. Okay, that one's doesn't seem very level, but we'll see. It can always be fixed. And I'm going to lay the other one, one of the other ones. And I have a little sticky left at the bottom, but that's okay. And what I'm going to do then is trim off the excess, and I will do that and be right back. So now I have this 9x12 sheet of designed. I'm going to zoom out a little bit so you can see that how pretty it is. So I didn't use all of the full sheet for this one or this side, but I did trim off, and I will keep this for use with a card or something. So there's a remaining sticky, there's remaining film on the back, and when I lift that off, then this will be sticky, a sticky sheet. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply it to my little mixed media paper sheet book. So for sketches or working with my different mediums. So I'm going to eyeball this a little bit and just kind of make a crease, so just I can kind of eyeball it, and I won't need to use this part when I cut the paper. So I'm just taking my fingers and making sure that no sticky edges. And you could either take a little bit of sandpaper over the edge if you want to make completely sure. Next time though, I'll either use scissors that are Teflon or nonstick or a craft knife, because you can see it sticks really well. So there you have it. What I can do then is leave this as it is and have my pretty little note mixed media paper pad with a little design cover. These are a quick and easy way to decorate paper, and then you can use them in many different applications for cards, collage, mixed media, whatever you want to use them for. So I hope you will give them a try.